ഹായ് ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, വെൽക്കം ടു ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് ബെൽ. ഹോപ്പ് യു ആർ ഓൾ സേഫ്. ഇൻ ദിസ് തേർഡ് യൂണിറ്റ് നേംഡ് ലോസ് ഓഫ് വാല്യൂസ് വി ഹാവ് ലേൺഡ് എ സ്റ്റോറി. വാട്ട്സ് ദ നെയിം ഓഫ് ദ സ്റ്റോറി? യെസ്, ദ ബെസ്റ്റ് ഇൻവെസ്റ്റ്മെൻറ്റ് ഐ ഹവ് മേഡ്. യെസ്, ഐ തിങ്ക് യു ഓ ഹാവ് എൻജോയ്ഡ് ദ സ്റ്റോറി വെരി മച്ച്. ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് വാസ് ദ സ്റ്റോറി റിയലി അബൌട്ട്? ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ഓൾ അബൌട്ട് വാല്യൂസ്. ആൻഡ് ഹു വാസ് ദ മെയിൻ ക്യാരക്ടർ ഓഫ് ദ സ്റ്റോറി? യെസ്, a young man. And what was the story about? The story was about the kindness shown to a boy or the young man. Now let us get into the poem, The Ballad of Father Gilligan, written by W.B. Yeats. Come on, first of all let us watch this video. What did you see? Yes, we know the situation. A virus is following the boy. And the boy is trying to avoid the virus. He is trying to keep away from the virus, isn't he? We are all trying to...
Hi. Hello.
Wait, we are all trying to avoid the virus. Who are you?
I'm a shepherd.
And where are you from?
I'm from a remote village.
Why are you here?
I want to tell you all a story.
Story?
Yes, a story.
What's your story about?
I saw your animation video. We, the people of our village, also had such experiences before.
An epidemic?
Yes, and my story is about a kind priest who served us in the time of epidemic. My story is about this old and kind priest and is about a miracle that happened in his life.
Priest? Who is the priest?
It is Father Peter Gilligan.
What's a miracle that happened in the life of the priest?
Let me sing his story.
Is it a song?
It is in the form of a song, a ballad.
Now, dear students, let us read and enjoy the poem, The Ballad of Father Gilligan, written by William Butler Yeats. W.B. Yeats is an Irish poet, and he was awarded Nobel Prize for Literature in 1923. You read his profile in the textbook and know more about him, okay? William Butler Yeats is an Irish poet and one of the foremost figures of 20th century literature. In 1923, he was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature for his inspired poetry. Yeats is one of the few writers who completed his greatest works after being awarded the Nobel Prize, which include The Tower, published in 1928, and The Winding Star and Other Poems, published in 1929. Have a look at the title of the poem. It's a ballad. And what does a ballad mean? It's a poem narrating a story. It's usually in short stanzas, stanzas of four lines or quatrains. There are many ballad-like narrative poems in all languages. In Malayalam, we have Vadakkan Paattukal, Thekkan Paattukal, and folk songs. They tell us interesting stories. Now, let us listen to a song. It's a famous Vadakkan Paattu. Famous heroine Unniyacha is getting ready to set out to a temple.
Kannadi noki tilagam thoo
Did you like the song about Unniyacha? Now please have a look at the picture. Who is this? Yes, Jidesh. Jidesh Kakadipuram. His folk songs are very much famous. Can you sing one? Yes. Listen to this song. It's a tribute to Jidesh.
கேட்டு கரையருது புண்ணு ஆய கதை ஞானு சொல்லித்தரா ஆய கதை கேட்டு கரையருது புண்ணு ஆய கதை ஞானு சொல்லித்தரா
Children, now open your textbook and listen to the poem.
The Ballad of Father Gilligan, written by W.B. Yeats. The old priest Peter Gilligan was weary night and day, for half his flock were in their beds or under green sod sleigh. Once, while he nodded in a chair at the moat tower of the inn, now the poor man sent for him, and he began to grieve. "I've no rest, nor joy, nor peace, for people die and die." But after cried he, "God forgive, my body spake not I." He knelt and leaning on the chair, he prayed and fell asleep. And the moth hour went from the fields and stars began to peep. They slowly into millions grew and leaves shook in the wind. And God covered the world with shade and whispered to mankind. Upon the time of sparrow chirp, when the moths came once more, the old priest Peter Gilligan stood upright on the floor. "Mavron, Mavron, the man has died while I slept in the chair." He roused his horse out of its sleep and rode with little care. He rode now as he never rode by rocky lane and fen. The sick man's wife opened the door. "Father, you come again?" "And is the poor man dead?" he cried. "He died an hour ago." The old priest Peter Gilligan in grief swayed to and fro. "When you were gone, he turned and died as merry as a bird." The old priest Peter Gilligan, he knelt him at that word. He who hath made the night of stars for souls so tired and bleed, sent one of those great angels down to help me in my need. He who is wrapped in purple robes with planets in his care, had pity on the least of things asleep upon a chair.
Have you finished the reading? And now let me ask you a question. Who is the main character of this poem? Yes, Father Peter Gilligan. And what's the situation? Yes, an epidemic is spreading in the village, and people are dying every day. Now, dear children, please read the first two stanzas.
The old priest Peter Gilligan was weary night and day, for half his folk were in their beds or under green sods lay. Once while he nodded in a chair at the mouth of the eve, another poor man sent for him, and he began to grieve.
Hope you have read it. How many unfamiliar words are there? Read the first word. What's it? Weary? Okay. What does it mean? Tired. Tired of continuous work. Weary person. A tired person. Next word, flock. Usually it means flock of sheep. But here it refers to the people in the parish. നമ്മൾ ഇടവക എന്ന് പറയുന്നില്ലേ, പള്ളിയുടെ ഇടവക, അതാണ് പാരിഷ് എന്ന വാക്കിൻ്റെ അർത്ഥം. Now come to the word grieve. What does it mean? Feel sorrow, feel sad. Okay. Next usage is in the beds. It means they are bedridden. They are sick. They are not well. They are ill. And the next usage is under green swords lay. What does it mean? Have a look at the picture. Green sword. And under green swords lay. That means they are dead and buried. Look at the next word, nodded. What does it mean? Moving one's head up and down like this. Nodded. And have a look at this movement. He shook his head. It means no. Not shake. Not shake. Okay. There is another word, eve. What does this word mean? It refers to a time, and it is a shortened form of a word. What's the word? Yes, tell me. Yes, it is evening. Moth hour. Another term is the, yes, look at the picture. Okay. And moth hour means it's a time when moths come in swamps. Moths appear in swamps. And it will be in the morning or it will be in the evening. And moth hour of the morning refers to dawn, and moth hour of the evening refers to dusk. അതിരാവിലെയും വൈകുന്നേരം വളരെ വൈകിയും നമുക്ക് ചുറ്റും ഒരുപാട് കൂട്ടങ്ങളോടെ ആ ചെറിയ പ്രാണികൾ പറന്നു വരുന്ന സമയമാണ് പ്രഭാതം പ്രദോഷം. മോത്ത് അവർ ഓഫ് ദ മോർണിംഗ് ആൻഡ് മോത്ത് അവർ ഓഫ് ദി ഈവനിങ്. വാട്ട് ഡു ദീസ് ടു സ്റ്റാൻസസ് ടെല്ലസ് അബൌട്ട് ഫാദർ പീറ്റർ ഗില്ലിഗൻ? ഹി ഈസ് വെരി ഓൾഡ്, ഹി ഈസ് വെരി, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഹി ഈസ് വെരി ടയേർഡ്. Because he works hard. He is very busy night and day. And what do we know about the people in his parish? Or the people under his control? Half of the people were either in beds or dead and buried. What does the picture indicate? Yes. It means some kind of epidemic is spreading there. Why was Father Peter Gilligan weary night and day? He treats the sick people and conducts burial of the dead. Yes, have a look at the picture. What's Father Peter Gilligan doing? He's sitting on a chair and he's taking rest. Now, a person, a poor man is coming to see him.
Please, come in. What can I do for you?
Oh, Father, a poor man near my house is sick. His situation is very, very bad. He is about to die.
Oh, poor man.
Father, he needs your help. So, Father, please, please come with me.
How unfortunate. Okay, I'm very tired, but I'll come.
Why was Father Peter Gilligan weary? He was weary or tired because he had been doing the priest's duty for the sick people, and he had been doing the funeral services for the dead. Why was Peter Gilligan unhappy? He was unhappy because half of his people were either in beds or died. So he was very tired of doing his duties. Dear students, now let us read the next two stanzas. Don't forget to note the unfamiliar words, okay?
I have no rest, no joy, no peace, for people die and die. And after cried he, God forgive, my body spake not I. He knelt, and leaning on the chair, he prayed and fell asleep. And the moth went for the fields, and stars began to peep.
What are the words that you find difficult? Spake. The word spake is used in Old English, which means spoke. And stars began to peep. It's a usage in the poem. What does the word peep mean? Peep means look. Okay? Here, stars began to peep. Can a star peep? No. So, there is a figure of speech in these lines. Okay? What's the figure of speech used here? Yes. Personification. You know it. Here, stars are considered as persons. Dear ones, Father Gilligan is complaining. What are his complaints? He has no rest. He has no peace. And he has no entertainment. And he is always very busy. Now, dear ones, please read the third stanza once again. Now let us see what Father Peter Gilligan says.
I have no time to rest, no joy, no entertainment, no peace of mind, because people die and die in my parish. Oh God, forgive me. My body spotless, not I.
What does my body spake mean? His body was very weak, but his mind was ready for the service. These words are from his weak body, not from his mind. Did Father Peter Gilligan go to the poor man's house? No. Okay. Why? Why didn't he go to the poor man's house? What happened to him? Yes, he slept on the chair. Okay? Shall we visualize these four stanzas in some other way? Okay, we have seen animations pictures, puppet shows, videos, etc. Now, how about a choreography? And what are the steps to create a choreography of these lines? First of all, we have to read these stanzas and pick up the images, and we have to organize them, write a script of these lines, and then add music, and we can present such a choreography. Would you like to watch a choreography done by some students?
The old priest, Peter Gilligan, was weary night and day. For half his flock were in their beds, or under graves or sleep. The old priest, Peter Gilligan, was weary night and day. For half his flock were in their beds, or under graves or sleep.
Have you enjoyed the choreography? How was it? Now, based on this choreography and your understanding about these lines, you prepare a summary of these four stanzas. Okay? And we know that Father Peter Gilligan is the main character of this poem. So let us begin like this. Father Peter Gilligan was an old priest. And what happened next? Some kind of epidemic is there. And the priest had his own duties. And some poor man came to him. But he couldn't go to the poor man's house. Okay, you know all these things. Add other points to your summary. Dear students, hope you have enjoyed the first part of this poem, the first four stanzas. And we shall meet again with another episode. Till then, goodbye. T.M. Damayandran, Government Higher Secondary School, Nedungom.